Hi and welcome to the Deep Glow version 1.3 update tutorial. So we've done a lot of work and rewritten a lot of Deep Glow just to make it a lot easier to use and harder to get bad results essentially. So the main complaint that we had is quality control settings weren't intuitive and they were really easy to get bad results with. So that was the main thing that we've been addressing. Now let's just go ahead and add Deep Glow. This is what it looks like at its default settings, and let's jump straight into the quality tab and you'll notice a few changes. The first thing we have is this auto iterations feature. So if we uncheck that, you'll notice the familiar glow iterations, and that's what we had in the previous version. But now the plugin is going to intelligently take care of how many iterations you should have so that you don't need to worry and that you'll always get the best result. As an example of that, let's just jump down to a really low radius of say 50 and let's turn auto iterations off, and we really won't notice much difference between 6 and 10 iterations. So at low radius, a higher amount of iterations is really just wasteful. If we were to increase the radius to the max of 2000, we would see this ugly result here that 6 iterations is definitely not enough and we kind of need 10. Auto iterations is going to take care of that, and it doesn't matter what your radius is set to, it's going to choose the most efficient and best looking settings. One situation where you may need to disable the auto iterations and change things manually is if you've got something that's really fine detail. For example, I've got a 2 pixel stroke here. The detail is very fine. And if we turn on Deep Glow with auto iterations, we'll see that it's not really enough. We can see if we turn off the source opacity from 0 to 100, we can see the source very clearly there and it just doesn't look very good. So in this situation, we might want to disable that and increase the glow iterations to the absolute maximum. But other than this situation, auto iterations should perform very well for you. The next thing we've worked on is the steps. So now you should really never need to change the step multiplier unless you're going for like a really funky stylistic result. In the previous version, if you had some very extreme aspect ratios, you would need to then massively increase the step count. However, now we've made this much more efficient and it doesn't matter what your aspect ratio is, the steps are going to be perfect for you. The downsample amount works similar to before, and that is that for each iteration that you have, each buffer gets a bit smaller. The problem was that at very low radiuses, that caused some really ugly artifacting. And so now we've got some extra checks and balances to make sure that those really low res buffers don't get displayed. The only thing to watch out for is if you have a really low downsample amount and a very high amount of iterations, it's not going to be able to display all those iterations because they're just too low res. And so you'll see here that the difference between 80% downsample and 50 is drastic, because at 80% we're actually able to show all 10 iterations, but at 50% downsample, the last iterations would be so low res that it would cause really disgusting aliasing. A value of 80 should suit your needs for nearly everything. The only time I would change this is if you're getting temporal flickering as you've got animation, or if you're doing a really low step stylistic result, increasing the downsample to 100 will give you a much cleaner result because you can actually see the detail on each step. Other changes we've made is the input threshold and threshold smooth now default to 0. We've also removed the smooth blending option and set that as always on, because the feedback we were getting is that that produced a better looking result. People were happier with that, so we thought, well, let's just always have that turned on. So that's it for this update. And in the next update, we're going to add some really cool stylistic features. We're going to have an angle for the aspect ratio. We're going to have some more options for these funky looking step results, as well as a mask for the input. So stay tuned for those in the next update of Deep Glow.